All right, good morning. It's Wednesday, April 10th. It's 10:40 in the morning. I'm not having a great day. I'll be very honest, very honest. I'm having a horrible day. But we're going to start with Baby Bob. Baby Bob thinks she's going to be the last man standing. She has an alternative plan today. And I just want to show her that the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air was talking about the main prerogative of the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air was to tell me that Miss Judy Garland, Judy P. Feliciano, has a unit near Bel-Air. Is the Colonial House in Bel-Air? No. Let me see something here really quick. You know, I gotta look at the map. You know, we got a lot of time left, but I only have 2 minutes left, man. Bel-Air. Los Angeles neighborhood, though. And this is Los Angeles neighborhood. We're gonna look at the map right now. Bel-Air is where Bel-Air? Right here. And there's a whole, this near this area, no, right here, though. No. Right here, though. And then she's on this, Bellagio Road. No. She's on Cascade. On Bellagio Road, though. What's on Bellagio Road? This building's about, she has an apartment unit on Bellagio Road, I think. It's this building, no, it's a big building, no. It's this apartment complex right here, the door. 11812, no, 11818. Let me see, 11818. And that's her last resource. That's what she has, 11818. Oh, Los Angeles, California. That's that building. Hold on, now we gotta do a thing here. Here, there's an old house on Bellagio Road. Yeah, no, it's off Bellagio Road, no. It's up on the hill of Bellagio Road, no. Okay, I see it. The apartment though. Anyway, she has a place and around this area, and it's unit 3A, so 2-bedroom, 2-bathroom, she brought. The closing date was 7/16/1982. No, she brought it in, supposedly for $75,000. Today, the worth is $1.795 million. It's furnished. She never been there. The name that she put on the D is Janice Leon. She put the date of birth 7/19/1953, my brother's birthday. So I'll please look at property records and change the deed over to my brother's name, my name, or whoever's name, so she has no place not to go. Thank you very much. Next, I want to talk about, I just got a PhD on this too. Moms that throw out their kids and don't want to take them back. They're having a very difficult time. When your parents throw you out, everybody throws you out of their place. I got thrown out of my own Starbucks today. I got thrown out of Joe and Juice by this crazy girl that just moved here 2 weeks ago from the town on the Cocoa Beach, which is the craziest Democrat town in the United States of America. It's the second craziest town. You don't understand. That town voted 97.9% for Joe Biden. You know, those people are crazy. You have to put a barbed wire fence around that town in Florida and leave it alone. Trust me, that girl is a crazy girl. And then I'm gonna talk. Trust me, parents who throw out the kids get thrown out of everywhere. She don't know the damage I'm going. Baby Bob doesn't know, so I'm asking the Hasidic community of New York City to perform a stampede on her. To contact my father, so we could perform a stampede on her. A stampede will fix her. So she never. Brian and Tony been through 7 stampedes. She never had a Hasidic stampede. Trust me, she needs a Jewish stampede. Trust me, she needs it ASAP. Please, in the next 24, 48, 72 hours, I don't care when. Please perform a stampede on Judith E. Feliciano. She really needs. It's like Lion King. Lion King shows the stampede, and he warned his mom. That's what's gonna happen to. They wanted to warn Simba's mom that that's what's gonna happen to her. That stampede. If she doesn't give up and give in, I'm tired of this. I'm very exhausted. Yesterday was a very tiring day for me. I'm still exhausted. I want to talk about the Bed-Stuy community. I want to talk to Bed-Stuy kids and people who move into Bed-Stuy. I'm only talking about them because a lot of these white girls, it's just the white girls, the crazy Democrat girls come to New York City and they want to room me with you guys. And please be very careful who you room me with in Bed-Stuy. It's a great community in Austrian. It means bespoken. And bespoken means be straightforward. And be straightforward means be honest. And be honest gives you integrity. Integrity means hard work. And hard work means success. And success means accomplishing your goals, and accomplishing your goals means making it to the end, to the top. And all of you guys make it to the top except those crazy bitches. And that's one crazy bitch that was enjoying the juice today that hit a coffee. And then I had a crazy immigrant Mexican that steals from everywhere, and he hides upstairs from the police at the Starbucks near on Fifth Avenue on near Best Buy on 50. That's 43rd Street. No, 44th Street. 44th Street, and on Fifth Avenue and Avenue of the Americas. That Mexican has to get arrested. He's calling me a faggot. He's calling me a mamaricho, and he don't even know me. I'm all the way on the other side. Like, how the fuck you even know me? And then I get kicked out of my own Starbucks because I'm from my own cousin that he doesn't even know we're cousins. And please show him this video because I freeze him. Anyway, the police roomies. I know black kids, Hispanic kids, the white kids. Please be careful with those white crazy bitches that look like they come from Portland, Oregon, but they racist as hell. Trust me, and they're very biased. Not, they don't belong in New York City. Trust me. You guys always make it, but they don't. You know, Bed-Stuy is the beacon point of success, and they're not the beacon point of success. They're the cock blockers of success. Anyway, that's all I have for now. Right now, all right. Take care, guys. All right.